Hello dear students and welcome to this online class video. This is the 7th part of the 4th chapter, Parts and Wholes of Class 5 subject Mathematics. Let's start the class. In today's class, we have our last topic, that is practice time. And we have many word problems in this practice time. So the first question is Rahim's journey. Okay, in the black color you can see the question. So Rahim has to travel one whole 1/4 kilometer to reach school. Okay, so I am making Rahim's home. Okay, and this is his school. Remember that. So the distance from his home to school is 1/4 kilometer. Okay, now what distance does he travel to go to school and come back home? So here we have to find the total distance. Total distance of his traveling. So one time he is going to school and second time he is coming back from school to home. So when he goes one time from home to school, so he is traveling 1/4 kilometer. And when he is coming back from school to home, so once again he is traveling 1/4 kilometer. So this total distance we have to calculate. Means you can add 1/4 and 1/4. Then you can get your answer. So how you will? Yes, in a simple way you can add this. So 1 and 1, these are whole numbers, so you will get 2. And you can also add 1/4 and 1/4. So let me add this clearly. So 1/4 plus 1/4. So in second step, these are the whole numbers, so 1 and 1 it will be 2. And in bracket you can add the fraction numbers, 1/4 plus 1/4. So at last you can write 2 whole. Now you know the addition of fractions. So here the denominators are equal, that is 4. So write 1 time 4, and 1 and 1 it will be 2. Then you can divide the numbers, fraction numbers. So 2 1 ja 2 and 2 2 ja 4. So you can write 2 whole 1/2. This is the total distance that he is traveling from school to home and home to school. So this is the first method. Now the second method is here. So in this way you can make your second solution. So given you can write first time, then you can write to reach the school Rahim has to travel 1/4 kilometer. It's a mixed fraction number and that is equal to 5/4 kilometer. You can convert in improper fraction. I have converted. Now from school to home is equal to 1/4 kilometer. Yeah, the distance will be same. 5/4 kilometer. Now at last you can write total distance traveled by Rahim. So here you can write 5/4 plus 5/4. Yes, both you will add. So total you will get 10/4. How it will be? It's very easy. 5/4 plus 5/4. Here you can see the denominators are 4, 4. I mean that is same. So 5 and 5 it will be 10/4. So I have written 10/4. Then you can divide this number 2 2 ja 4 and 2 5 ja 10. So 5/2 here I have written. Then when you will divide this number 5/2, so you will get 2/1/2. How it will be? Let me divide the number. So 5 it will be your dividend and 2 will be your divisor. So 2 2 ja it will be 4. So we have 1 as remainder. So now you can write it. The divisor is here, so write divisor 2. Then this is your remainder, so here you will write in the place of numerator and you will get the division line. Then the quotient you will write in the denominator, so you are getting a mixed fraction number, that is 2/1/2. And here I have written this. So in the second method we have also found 2/1/4 kilometer. Now come to the second question. The second question is related to coins, but before going to second question I want to ask a question. That what is the distance from your home to school, that you will write in the comment section, and also you will write your school name. So clear, you have to write the distance from your home to your school. That may be 500 meter, 1 kilometer, 2 kilometer, 5 kilometer or 10 kilometer. So don't forget to comment. Now come to the second question. What coins? So second question, Lata bought a pencil and a pen for 7.5 rupees. So remember that 7.5 rupees, and this is the symbol of Indian rupees. She gave 10 rupees to the shopkeeper. Yes, she gave 10 rupees. The shopkeeper gave back the money in half and quarters. So half means 1/2. This is half. So half of 1 rupee will be 50 paise. And quarters. Quarters means 1/4. So 1/4 of 100 rupees will be 25 paise. Clear? This is the quarter of 1 rupee. So what are the coins she got? So first we have to find that how much money she is getting back. So here is the solution. First write given, then statements are here. Lata bought a pencil and a pen for 7.5 rupees. I have written this. Money given by Lata to the shopkeeper, 10 rupees she gave to the shopkeeper. Now that I was asking to you, here is that how much money she is getting back from the shopkeeper. So for that we have to subtract 10 from 7.5 rupees. 7.5 rupees means 7 rupees and 50 paise. So here you can write shopkeeper gave back the money is equal to 10 rupees minus 7.5 rupees. So she is getting 2 rupees and 50 paise. So this is the amount she is getting back. So this rupees means 2 rupees and 50 paise. So this amount the shopkeeper will give to Lata in halves means 50 paise and quarters means 25 paise. In the combination of 50 paise and 25 paise, the shopkeeper will return the 2 rupees and 50 paise to Lata. So here are the ways that the shopkeeper can return as 2.5 rupees in the following ways. So the first is 1/2 rupee coin and 8/4 rupee coins. Yes. And then the second, 2/2 rupee coins means 250 paise and 6/4 rupee coins means 625 paise. Now the third way is 3/2 rupee coins means 350 paise and 4/4 rupee means 425 paise. And at last, 4/2 rupee coins means 450 paise and 2/4 rupee coins means 250 paise. So these are the ways that the shopkeeper will return 2 rupees and 50 paise to Lata. I hope that you have understood that question. Now, next question we have related to railway stations. Now, question is at the railway station. So your attention please, Mangalore Express. This is the train name, Mangalore Express. Coming from Mangalore and going to Thiruvananthapuram is now running late by half an hour. So the train is late today. The right time is 6:45. So first of all, you have to know that the train timing is always in hours. So here is 7. 7 means 7 hours. It means this is the morning time, not evening time. If the train is coming at evening 7 o'clock, so that will be 19 hours. Remember that, okay? Actually, at the home, we write 7 a.m., 7 p.m. So, but the train doesn't use that time, a.m., p.m. That use only, that runs, the train time always runs in hours. Means 24-hour clock is used for the train timing. So, these are the timings of 24 hours. So, remember that. Now, so the first question is here. What time is the train expected to come today? So the right time is 6:45. 6:45 means, here I have written the solution. The right time is 6:45 means 6:45 hours. Okay, quarter means less 15. Always remember that. Means 7 hours you have to minus from the 15 minutes. So you will get 6:45. Clear? So this is quarter. 15 means quarter. Now, but train is delayed by half an hour. Half an hour means 30 minutes. So exact time train will arrive 6:45 hours plus 30 hours. So total it will be 7:15 hours. Clear? So the train is coming now at 7:15 hours. And now come to the second question. Nazia gets off at a station after 2.5 hours. From this station, what time will she get off? So here we have to find the timing of getting off by Nazia. So the solutions are here given. Nazia gets off at a station after 2 hours and 30 minutes. So 2:30 hours we will write. Then the total time taken by Nazia to reach, we have to add. So 230 hours plus 715 hours. So total 945 hours. So this time is this is the time when Lata Nazia will get off from the train. Now question number C, we have Shazi will take 5 hours to reach Ernakulam. Ernakulam is a station name, by this train. So Mangalore train is now reaching to Ernakulam. At what time will he reach there? So here we have a timing of 5 hours. So we have to know that what was the exact timing of train coming, that was 7:15 hours, and now 5 hours is taking more, so we have to add 5 hours. So how you will write the statements? So here are the statements given. What is given? Shazi will take 5 hours to reach Ernakulam. So total time taken by Shazi to reach Ernakulam is equal to 7:15 hours plus 5 hours, as I have told you before sometime. So total it will be 7 plus 5, 12 hours and 15 minutes. In this way, you have solved this all word problems. And if you have any doubt, so you can comment your doubt in the comment section. I will definitely try to clear that up. And at last, I want to say, if you like this video, so please subscribe my channel. And at last, I want to say that stay at home, be healthy. Till then, bye-bye.